Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Heavenly Father, Holy Spirit, we ask that you continue to move here in the building today. Father, I ask that you prepare the soils and the hearts of the listeners and the hearers this morning as they would be prepared to hear your word. You say that not one of your words goes out in void, that it goes out with an intended purpose. Father, I thank you so much this morning for the preacher. I thank you for Pastor Michael. I ask that you use him today in a mighty way. Father, would you open the ears for those who have ears to hear this morning? Would you allow them to hear? We drive you out, Satan. You're not welcome here. We banish you in the mighty name of Jesus. We have authority in the name of Christ, and we demand that you leave right now.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. May your word go out today. In Jesus' mighty name, we all say,
amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Turn your Bibles to Matthew 16, 19. Your Bibles to Matthew 16, 19. And the Bible says, and I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whenever you bind, no, whatever you bind, whatsoever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Glory to God. Let's look at Romans chapter 5, verse 2. Through whom also we have access by faith into this grace in which we stand, and we rejoice in the glory of God. Look at your neighbor and ask him, have you accessed the kingdom? Have you accessed the kingdom? Have you accessed the kingdom? I want to talk for a moment about accessing the kingdom of God. Anybody want to know about pressing into a new dimension of God? I want to use the story of Joshua leading the Israelites to the promised land to extract some kingdom principles about accessing the kingdom. Mm-hmm. We as believers are not just supposed to be aware of the kingdom. We're called to access it. We're called to live it. Mm-hmm. In fact, when the disciples asked Jesus, teach us how to pray, you know, Jesus said, this is how you pray, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Ooh, glory be to God. Watch this. We have access to the kingdom through Jesus. Now, where does Joshua fit in all of that? You see, Joshua is an Old Testament picture of Jesus. Mm-hmm. As Joshua is leading the nation of Israel into the promised land, watch what Jesus is doing, Shayla. Let's go to 2 Corinthians. You did a good job today, Shayla. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 20. All of y'all did. So while in the Old Testament, Jacob was leading the Israelites to the promised land, the Bible says, for all these promises of God now in him who? In Jesus is yes, and in him who? Jesus, in Jesus is amen for the glory. Hallelujah. You see, there was a promised land, but the Bible says now the promises are in Jesus. You see that? You see that? Mm-hmm. But Jesus led us into the promises. You see, Joshua led them into the promised land, but now we're connected to Jesus, and he leads us into the promises in him. Mm-hmm. But our promises are yes in Jesus, but we have to say amen. Okay. We have to consent. We have to consent. That means so be it. We have to mentally embrace and to open our hearts to those promises that are yes. The kingdom is there, but We have to access it. Ooh, glory to God. We have to amen it. We have to amen it. We have to step into it. I want to ask somebody today, is your life an amen to Jesus? I wonder if we just take a peek in their Facebook page, is it an amen to Jesus? I wonder if we go to their webpage, Kyle, I wonder if it says amen Jesus. I wonder if I would just sit in the back seat of your car when you're arguing with your wife. I wonder, is there an amen to Jesus? I wonder, you girlfriend, boyfriend, if I hear it in the other room, would I hear a amen? Okay. Would I hear an amen to Jesus? Is your life an amen? I wonder when your coworker is getting on your nerves. I wonder, is your life an amen to Jesus? Ooh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The kingdom is there, but we have to access it. Mount Zion, in order to access the kingdom, one of the most important things is that we have to do is we have to grow. If we're going to access the kingdom of God, then we have to grow. Then we're going to have to grow. Eric, we have become satisfied with a surface relationship with Jesus. We've become satisfied with a surface relationship with Jesus. But I come to tell us this Sunday morning, we got to grow. I come to tell us this Sunday morning, we got to grow. Watch this. God, preacher, thinks in threes. He reveals in threes. He grows in threes. Watch this. When Jesus was telling us about sowing, he said in his teaching, he said, some who seek me yielded 30-fold. And then he said, some came a little deeper and they yielded 60-fold. And then he said, some were sold out and they were so hungry that they gave all in and they reaped 100-fold. Come on. I heard Jesus introduce himself. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Come on. Jesus said about these things that remain, he said, there's faith, there's hope. And he said, when you really press in, the greatest of the three is love. I want to help us because Jesus grows us in threes, Rachel. He said, and I'm glad he said this. He said, when I start pruning you, there's fruit. He said, but hold on just a little while longer because when I start pruning you, there's more fruit. He said, but hold on, Rachel, just a little while longer because when I start pruning you, if you really hold on, there's much fruit. Ooh, come on. Jesus says, out of Egypt, through the wilderness, into the promise. Okay. I hear God saying, tabernacle. I hear God saying, tabernacle. Tabernacle. Teach them. Let me teach. You see, in the tabernacle, when they went in the outer court, they went in the outer court, and there was a brazen altar, and there was a brazen laver. And when they went in through the outer court, that's a picture of Jesus on the cross. You see, because at the sacrifice of the altar, at the brazen laver where we be baptized, that's a picture of Jesus. That's the outer court. Watch this. They call that the evangelical dimension. That's the saving dimension. But the problem is, some of us get to the evangelical dimension and we stop right there. Oh, I'm saved. Let me get in the bleachers. But I don't want to teach and preach and shepherd a church that wants to stay in the evangelical dimension. You see, in the tabernacle, the priest had to move to grow. You see, they moved from the, glory to God, I feel the Holy Ghost. They moved from the outer court to the inner court. And when they moved to the inner court, the Bible says there was a lamp
in the inner court, Iskra, and the lamp had seven bowls. Iskra and the seven bowls meant the seven spirits of God. And then they said in the inner court was the showbread table. That represents the word of God. The Bible says the word is a lamp at my feet. But then he said in the inner court was the incense, the altar of incense, because there was prayer, praise, and worship in the inner court. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see, in the inner court was a Pentecostal experience. In the inner court is where the Holy Ghost was. You see, so the priests, they moved from the evangelical dimension to the Pentecostal experience, the Pentecostal dimension. And I love a Pentecostal church, but I don't want to stay in a evangelical state. I don't want to stay in the Pentecostal experience. You see, Rachel, yeah, we went through the evangelical dimension, and we went through the Pentecostal experience, and I hear Jesus say, come on, come on, come on, come on, y'all, we got to grow, we got to grow, we got to go to the next dimension, you got to go to the Holy of Holies. You see, when he went in the Holy of Holies, that's where the glory was. You see, in the outer court, the sun lit it up. In the inner court, the Holy Ghost lit it up. But in the Holy of Holies, the glory, the Shekinah glory was lighting up. We got to get to the Holy of Holies. We got to access the kingdom and rest in the glory of God. There is a third dimension. Oh, glory, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Watch this. Jesus is the tabernacle. So to us New Testament believers, Jesus is the tabernacle. So if we're going to grow, we have to grow in Jesus. If we're going to grow, we have to grow in Jesus. Listen, we've got to grow in order to access the kingdom. Watch this. Look at what the Bible says. Because if it ain't Bible, let's look at 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 18, because we got to grow. James, turn that on and off. The Bible says, but grow in the grace. But grow. This is Jesus saying, but grow in the grace and the knowledge of our Lord and Savior, because to him be the glory. New Testament believers, we got to grow in Jesus, but it's time to grow. If we're going to access the kingdom, we got to grow in Jesus. Watch this. So you know how I teach. You know how I preach. I always try my best in the Holy Ghost to make it applicable so that we get a word in an applicable experience that we can leave here and apply it right now. Because I don't know about you, but I got some devils to fight. You see, when I preach a word, it was on me first. So I know on Monday, on Sunday night, the devil's trying to steal this word from me. Anybody ever had that? That you go hear a word and it hits you, and then on Monday or Tuesday something comes up and you have to go back and repent, say, dang it, I just heard that and I missed it. I'm the only one? Come on. Come on, somebody. Come on. Are this a real church or what? Let me give you three principles in where we have to grow if we're going to access the kingdom of God, us. Because I have to get us ready for the last revival. Amen? Principle number one, if we're going to grow, we need to think differently. Number one, we need to think differently. We need to think differently. Watch this. Let me show you something in Joshua. Let's look at Joshua chapter 1, verse 1 through 2. The Bible says, look at this. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, the Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses, your aid, watch this, Moses, my servant, is dead. Watch this. Now then, you and all the rest of Mount Zion, get ready. Get ready. Get ready. Get ready to cross over into the Jordan. I'm giving you this land. J is already ours. I'm not talking about getting something that don't belong to you. We serve an already God. God didn't wait till you needed it to supply it. He's sovereign. He worked the end from the beginning. That's why they call him the Ancient of Days, Shayla, because he went to the end and he fixed it for you, Shayla, and he backed up and he said, come on, Shayla, I got it covered. God fixed it from the end to the beginning. Watch this. He said, my servant Moses is dead. Now watch this. Now it's interesting that the Lord is telling Joshua that Moses is dead. And he's saying, Moses is dead and you people get ready to go on in and access the kingdom. Moses is dead and you people get ready to go head on to the promised land. Watch this. God is... Now Joshua knows that Moses is dead. Joshua was there. He knows that Moses is dead. But here's God saying, by the way, Joshua, did you get the memo that Moses is dead? Moses is dead. Watch this. When God sends a word, he's not trying to give you information. When God sends a word, he's trying to do mental transformation. When God sends a word, it's about revelation so that you would have mental transformation. He said, Moses is dead. God is saying, if you're going to access the kingdom, Joshua, Moses is dead. You got to move on. And Joshua, if you're going to access the kingdom, there's some things that you're going to have to leave behind. Watch this. You got to separate yourself from things that represent yesterday. Come on, somebody. You have to separate from some stuff in your past. You got to grasp what's in your future. If you hold on tight to where you've been, you'll never be able to embrace where you going. Come on. Do you remember when God told Moses, he said, Moses, go tell my people, go tell Pharaoh to let my people go. Moses said, what? Wait a minute, God. I've been hiding from dude for 40 years. He been trying to kill me. He got armies and everything. And you sending me back by myself, talk about let my people go? Well, then who do I tell them send me, God? He said, tell them the I am. Watch this. He didn't say, tell them, Shayla, the I was. He said, tell them the I am. He did not say I was. He said, tell him the I am, meaning I'm doing something right now. You see, everything that has to do with God has nothing to do with what's behind us. I got a word for somebody today. God's not concerned with where you've been. He's concerned with where you at and where he wants you to go. Oh, glory to God. I hope somebody heard that today. That's a word for somebody today. You know, in 1 Samuel, the Bible talks about how God had replaced Saul. And he sent Samuel to tell Saul, you're done. Move on to David. And Samuel, you know, he got kind of personal. You know, he's stuck on Saul. That's my buddy, God. Wait a minute. Where's your mercy? God said, shut up, get up, get your horn, fill it with oil, and move on. Now, it's interesting, if you didn't pay attention to this, Minister Frank, you wouldn't catch the revelation knowledge in it. Because what he said was, Samuel, get up, fill your oil, fill your horn with oil, leave the Saul, and move to the David. Now, remember, David, the Bible says, is a man after God's own heart. What is God saying? He's saying, if you don't leave my path, if you don't leave your path, you won't know the heart of God. He said, oh, you got to get that, Anna. He said, you got to leave that Saul and go on to your David and fill your horn with oil and get up and move on to David. David, a man after God's own heart. God's saying, if you don't leave your past, how you going to know my heart? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. God is getting ready to release a brand new anointing on us. God is saying, fill your horn, Mount Zion, and go forward in 2021. Mount Zion, go forward in 2021 towards 2022. Hey, Moses is dead. Wait a minute. 2021 is dead. 2019 is dead. 2015 is dead. 2010 is dead. 9, 8, 7, 6 is dead. Moses is dead. Get up and move on. Whew. Watch this. The devil don't care what you believe. He don't care about how many scriptures you know as long as you're living in the past. The devil only becomes afraid of you when you begin to recognize the I am in you now. Whew, glory to God. Munch, I'm preaching good in here today. Watch this. The Pharisees and the Sadducees were so stuck in the old laws of Moses that they couldn't see the Jesus working in front of their face right now. Come on, good God Almighty. God is doing something right now. God is doing something right now. One of the greatest issues of accessing the kingdom is not the issue, but it's what you think about the issue. It ain't even an issue, Nate. Because do you think that your issue caught God by surprise? You think God up there saying, oops, I didn't think Nate was going to dream like that. Oh, let me stop. Did you think that God was sitting on his stand saying, oops, I didn't think Pastor Michael was going to make that mistake. Uh-oh, all them church people going to crucify him now. I don't care. God took into account everything I was going to do, good, bad, and indifferent. He knew me before my mama's womb, and he called me to preach. He knew what I would do before I did it. He had a solution for me before I had the problem. The issue ain't the problem. It's how we thinking about it. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. The kingdom of God is not about the past. The kingdom of God is about right now. Jesus said the kingdom of God is at hand. When Jesus came to preach, he said, shut up. The kingdom of God is at hand. The kingdom of God is now. If Jesus is in you, and the Bible says God is in Jesus, Jesus is in God, and Jesus is in you. If Jesus is in you, the kingdom of God is at hand right now. Right now. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. God is moving now. Mount Zion, the door is open now. As a matter of fact, the door has been open waiting on us. The door has been open, waiting on us. Let's go back to the Bible. Let's go back to Joshua chapter 1, verse 3. Look at what the Bible says. The Bible says, I will give you every place where you set your feet, as I promised Moses. I'll give you every place you set your feet is yours. Watch this. The kingdom of God is not about a God of just enough.
He's a God of more than enough. Oh, I said, we're going to access the more than enough. We got to step out. Preacher, you got to step out. If you're going to access the kingdom, we got to step out. Preacher, if we're going to grow, you got to step out. Come on, somebody. No more church as usual. No more same old, same old. I don't want to do church like everybody else. I don't want to do what everybody else is doing. I don't want to be like everybody else is being, because there is a unique anointing on Mount Zion Tabernacle Church. You know what I like about Mount Zion Tabernacle Church? You see, most churches that you go to, and I don't talk bad about churches ever, ever. I don't care what the pastor does. You'll never hear me do that. But I want to say this. A lot of churches are so similar. Change the song here, change the program there, but it's same old, same old. But when you come to Mount Zion, you know whether or not you want to be in here. See, we don't have to worry about no other church being just like us, or no other church being so similar that you might go here this week and you might go there next week. When you come to Mount Zion, you know this your home, because we different. Come on. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. 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 Whew. There is a unique anointing on you. Watch this. Watch this. Preacher, I don't want to be born original and die a carbon copy. Wait a minute. I don't want to die a carbon copy. I don't want to be born extraordinary and die ordinary. Whew. I don't want to be born original and die like a carbon copy. You got to take steps with your life. You got to take steps with your ministry. Come on, somebody. I remember Christine when my first daughter was a baby. And Miss Christine, and she was learning to walk. And she would grab hold of stuff. And we just sit back like, there she go, there she go. And she grabbed something, Christine, right? And she braced herself up. And she start walking, right? And she start waddling. And when she get ready to fall, she put her hands up. And she put her hands up because she knew Daddy would pick her up. I come to tell somebody today, if we gonna step out, we gotta step out with our hands up. Hands up. You got to step up with your hands up. That's why worship is so important. I don't know if you've ever been arrested by the Holy Ghost, but when you get arrested by the Holy Ghost, you got to come out with your hands up. Come out with your hands up. If we coming out, if we going to access the kingdom, we got to come out with our hands up. Whew. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. If I'm going to jail, if I got to go, they too holy, man. I got to talk to you, preacher, because they too holy. If they going to come get me, woo, lock me up, Holy Ghost. Oh, lock me up, Holy Ghost. I surrender, Holy Ghost. I'm coming out, Holy Ghost. Is there anybody want to surrender to the Holy Ghost? Hey, hey. Oh, my God. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. If we're going to access the kingdom, we got to think differently. If we're going to access the kingdom, we got to think differently. Watch this. Number two. We got to see ourselves differently. If we're going to access the kingdom, we have to see ourselves differently. Come on, somebody. Come on, we got to see ourselves differently. Let's look at the Bible, Joshua 1. Let's go back. Joshua chapter 1, verse 5. Watch this. The Bible says, no one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, I'll be with you. God is no respecter of person. He cannot do one thing for one person in the Bible that he's not willing to do for me and you. I didn't say he would, but he's got to be willing. It's got to be available to me and you. So when he said, as I was with Moses, I'm with you. Just put your name in there. As I was with Moses, I'm with you, preacher. If I was with Moses, I'm with you, pastor. If I was with Moses, I'm with you, armor bearer. If I was Moses, I'm with you, son. You see, if I was with Moses, I'll be with you. Oh, glory be to God. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. In order for Joshua to access the promised land or the kingdom, he had to change how he saw himself. He had to change how he saw himself. Watch this. Do you see yourself strong or do you see yourself weak? Come on. Do you see yourself, watch this, watch this. Do you see yourself as victorious or do you see yourself as defeated? Come on, come on, come on. Do you see yourself as in Jesus or do you see yourself as alone? Come on. Some of us are in here today and the problem that we have is you don't see yourself like God sees you. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. When you, watch this, watch this. When you see yourself through the eyes of what you've been through and not through the eyes of what you're going to, let me say it over here. When you begin to see yourself in view of what you've been through instead of what you're going to, when you begin to see yourself by what you've been through and not see yourself by what God has taken you to, fear gets in. Not only fear, but when you begin to look at yourself by what you've been through, I've been through some stuff. But if I stay in that, if I see myself in that, then I won't see myself what I'm going to, and I'll begin to operate in feelings. Let me tell you something. Shiloh, if you drive your car and fear is driving or feelings are driving, I guarantee you, you're going to crash or you're going to bend up in the wrong place. If anybody in here, if fear is driving your car, if feelings are driving your car, you're going to end up, let me just tell you something about operating in feelings. Watch this, precious. When you operate in feelings, you're making blind decisions. Well, let me break it down to you. Isaac was blind. And Rebecca took Jacob, and she said, put some fur on your arm, and then go in there and let Isaac feel your arm. And when he feels your arm, let him make a decision. Isaac felt Jacob's arm, and he made a blind decision. When you operate on feelings, you make blind decisions. Don't let feelings dictate your decisions, or you're operating blindly. I tell my ministers all the time, and they'll tell you, don't speak out of emotion. Never speak out of emotion. I didn't say out of the Holy Ghost. I said out of emotions. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Let me go here. Watch this. Watch this, because we're talking about identity. We're talking about principle number two. Change how you see yourself. If we're going to grow, if we're going to access the kingdom of God, Shiloh, we have to change how we see ourselves. Watch this, Shiloh. There's a man in the Bible. His name was Mephibosheth. And Mephibosheth was Jonathan's nephew. David was asking his guys one day. He said, is any of Jonathan's relatives still alive so I can bless them? And his boys went searching all through the books. Now, Mephibosheth was hiding in a town called Lodabar. Lodabar means living beneath your blessings. And he was hiding in Lodabar because at a baby, somebody dropped him and broke his ankles and deformed him. Anybody in here ever been dropped? Anybody in here ever been let down? Anybody in here ever been hurt?
Anybody in here ever been disappointed? Anybody in here ever been stabbed in the back? You don't have to run to Lodabar. Let me tell you what happened. Mephibosheth went to Lodabar because he was ashamed, because he had been dropped. He was disabled. He was deformed. And he thought, I'm ashamed. Wait a minute. I can't do this. And David said, go get Mephibosheth and put him at the king's table. I come to tell somebody today, you belong at the king's table. Wait a minute. He took Mephibosheth and he put him at the king's table. But what the Bible doesn't tell is when you sit at the king's table has skirts that hang real low. Luke, they hang real low. And when you slide up under the king's table, whatever's from the waist down is hidden by the skirts. So they took Mephibosheth and they scooted him up to the king's table, and the king's skirt on the table covered his defectiveness. I want to tell somebody today, you belong at the king's table. And when you sit at the king's table, his skirt covers your defect. When you sit at the king's table, his skirt covers your weakness. When you sit at the king's table, his skirt covers your shame. When you sit at the king's table, his skirt covers your past. Oh, hey, stop looking at me like you're crazy. The skirt covered it. The skirt covered it. The skirt covered it. Oh, my God, I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. Woo. Hallelujah. 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 We must be careful not to confuse God's constants with our variables. So good right there. We must be careful not to confuse God's constants with our variables. What are you saying, preacher? God is constant. He does not change. God is constant. His love does not change. God is constant. His position does not change. He says, I'll never leave you and never forsake you. But the stuff that we go through is our variables. Is our variables. Now watch this. You hurt? It's a variable. Won't be there long. You're unemployed? It's a variable. Won't be there long. You're sad? It's a variable. Won't be there long. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. You're broke, it's a variable. Won't be there long. Accessing the kingdom. Number one, you gotta think differently. Number two, you gotta see yourself differently. But number three, your faith has to be different. Your faith has to be different. Your faith has to be different. Number three, your faith has to be different. God told Joshua, Butch, three times. He said, be strong and of good courage. There go them threes again. He said, be strong and of good courage. He said, be strong and of good courage. What was he saying, Anna? He said, let your faith be strong and of good courage. Is anybody in his faith strong and with courage? Let your faith be strong and of courage. Watch this. Watch this. If you're going to access the promised land, if you're going to access the kingdom, you got to have a different kind of faith, a faith that's strong and courageous. Watch this. In order to access the kingdom, your faith has to trust God even when it doesn't make sense. In order to access the kingdom, this is a different kind of faith. This is what I'm talking about, different kind of faith. Your faith has to trust God even when it doesn't make sense. Oh, come on, somebody. Even when it doesn't make sense. Joshua had to go through Jericho before he could get to the promised land. And the instructions God gave him didn't make sense. But your faith got to be a different faith in this season. You're going to have to rest in Jesus. Some people only got faith when they see God move. Some people only got faith when they see God move. God told Joshua, walk around the wall six times. And God gave him a strange strategy. But I come to tell you,
a different faith. Principle number three, the different faith I'm talking about, a different faith is trusting God when it doesn't make sense. But God is saying, if I don't do it on the first day, keep believing, keep walking. If I don't do it on the second day, keep believing, keep walking. You see, he told Joshua, he said, go around that big old wall, that big old army, that big old problem, that big old confusion, that big old deficit, that big old issue. He said, walk around it six times. So Joshua and his people, they walked around it two times. Some of us have been praying 2 days and we want to quit. He said, keep on believing, keep on walking. Mm-hmm. And he said, on the third day, he said, walk around again, walk around again. Oh, watch this. I hear the Holy Ghost telling me to tell you, I'll share this with you. A woman called me last week as she was crying profusely on the phone. She said, Pastor, I went to court and the judge denied me. She was so upset, she said, the system don't work for me. Forget it. She was crying badly, hurt. I said, wait a minute. So I reminded her about the story in the Bible. I said, you remember the woman in the Bible who went to see the judge? And the judge said to the woman, he said, get on out of here. I don't care if you're a Christian or not. But the woman kept on knocking. He said, no, go ahead. Get on out of here. Oh, Rachel, boy, he said, mm-mm. I got to talk to you. I'm a mama bear. Mm-mm. I'm serious about my issue, Mr. Judge. Mm-mm. And she kept on knocking. And then sooner or later, the judge said, go get that woman and bring her in here. He said, I'm going to see about her case because she just keep on bothering me. What I love about the story, Butch, though, but then Jesus said, when I come back, I want to find faith like that. I want to find the woman. I want to find the man that keeps on knocking. I want to find a woman. I want to find a man that keeps on asking. I want to find a woman. I want to find a man that keeps on praying. I want to find a woman. I want to find a man that keeps on walking. I want to find a woman. I want to find a man that keeps on believing, that keeps on knocking. So the woman of God said, I hear you, Pastor. I'm going back. So the same day, I'll tell you a true story. The same day, she went back home and she rewrote her petition and went back to court. The judge granted her petition, and the woman called me on the phone shouting, woo! The judge granted my petition. Hey! Don't tell me what my God won't do when you got a different kind of faith. You can access the kingdom of God. Wait a minute. So they went around the building four times. The big old wall, ma'am. The big old problem. I've been lonely for 4 years. I quit. I ain't been married 4 years now, God. I'm done. God said, go back around again. Don't stop believing. Don't stop asking. He said, go back around again, Joshua, fifth time. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And then he said, go back around a sixth time. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. He went back around a sixth time. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And he said, now the seventh time, I need you to do something a little different. He says, I need you to shout. How many of you know that when you shout, that when you praise, when praises go up, the glory of God comes down? He told him, you go head on and shout. You go head on and shout. Oh, wait a minute. I remember in my spirit about the story of Zechariah. Oh, wait a minute, Nate. Watch this. Zechariah, the Bible says, was building a temple. And the Bible says Zechariah couldn't complete his temple. It was not finished. Anybody went to God and said, God, when is this going to be over? Anybody ever had a prayer to God? God, when am I going to be delivered? God, when is this going to be complete? God, when are they going to stop? God, when am I going to be healed? God, when am I getting out? God, when am I coming up? God, when is it my turn? God, what? God, what? God, what? Hey! And he went to Zechariah, went to God, and he said, God, when is this temple going to be finished? And God said to Zechariah, he said, hey, let me tell you something, pal.
He said, your latter days shall be greater than your former days. I come to tell somebody today, the glory in your latter days shall be greater than the glory in your former days. Wait a minute. So then Zechariah was bold. He said, okay, God, that's good news, but when? He said, God, but when? Anybody ever asked God when? Wait a minute. So when they asked God when, God said, listen, pal, not by your might, not by your power, but by my spirit. But by my spirit. Watch this. So God told Zechariah, he said, Zechariah, go back to the temple and shout at the temple, grace, 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 grace. Oh, wait a minute. Why is it that God would tell Joshua? Why is it that God tells Zechariah to shout? Chris, watch this. Why did he tell him to shout? I got to tell you, Chris, because there's something about the sound of praise. There's something about the sound of praise. Watch this. When your sound goes up 700 octaves, your sound becomes light. And when your sound becomes light, that light becomes energy. And when that light becomes energy, that energy becomes a mass. Oh my God. When that energy becomes mass, that mass becomes matter. I come to tell you this Sunday morning, your shout matters. 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 I heard the Spirit speak. I heard the Spirit speak. He said, let the redeemed say so. Let the redeemed say so. If you've been healed, say so. If you've been delivered, say so. If you've got joy, say so. If you got peace, say so. If you got prosperity, say so. If you the head and not the tail, say so. If you above and not beneath, say so. Oh my God. If you got victory in Christ Jesus, say so. If you, oh my God. Hey, if no weapon formed against you shall prosper, say so. Oh my God. Hey, if you a child of the Most High God, say so. Oh, wait a minute. Woo. Hey, ma'am, your shout matters. I want to tell somebody today that today's the day. Today's the day that your situation is going to shift in the shout. Today's the day. Today's the day that your wall is coming down in the shout. Minister, I need you to turn that thing into an organ. We're going to take the roof off. Today's the day that you're going to access the kingdom in your shout. I don't care about your makeup. I don't care about your shirt. That's it. I don't care about your little pristine posture. Today, we're going to shout the roof off. Because today, situations going to shift. Today, it's going to shift. Today, the wall's coming down. Today, we're going to be delivered. Today is the day. Today is the day. Today is the day. On the count of three. On the count of three. On the count of three. Let that shout go. One, two, three. Shout. Yeah. Come on, minister. I need an organ. Come on. Shout. 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 Yeah. 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 That's it, Jocelyn. That's it, Jocelyn. Shout. Hey. Yeah. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Woo. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo. I hear the Holy Ghost saying, some chains have been broken. Yes, Lord. I hear the Holy Ghost saying, some situations have been shifted. Oh, that's it, Frank. I hear the Holy Ghost saying, some walls have come down. I hear the Holy Ghost saying, somebody has access to the kingdom of glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you believe it today? Give God glory. Give God glory. Come on up, ushers.
Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. God has spoken. Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen.
Yes, yes, yes.
Let the church say amen.
Yeah, 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 yeah. That right there, just make you want to get up and dance with your wife, go to Kyle. But you can do that here, man. We free in here, Kyle. I promise you we are. I'll let the Holy Ghost move in this place, bro. Let's worship our way out.
Let the
we worship our way in, and we worship our way out.
Let the church say amen.
Yes, yes, yes.
God has
come on,
spoken.
Okay, come on.
Let the church
yes, yes.
say amen.
Come on, okay. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Let the church say amen.
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 To whatever you're going through.
Amen.
You be there for you.
Amen.
God has spoken. Let the church say amen.
Yeah.
Oh,
put the scripture up, Robert. Keep going softly, y'all. Now, I know y'all see these people with these baskets. There are a few people in here new. But let me explain something to you. For us, giving is a heart issue. If a preacher tells you what to give, he should be in charge of your return. Giving is between you and Jesus. God's not blessing you because I preach good. He's blessing you because your heart is obedient to him. That's not about money. God will stick favor on your bloodline, Jew, that your kids' kids will be blessed because of your obedience. Ain't no IRA, ain't no house, ain't no bank account can trump God's favor. Come on. I'm talking about the favor of the Lord. The favor of the Lord. Anybody want the favor of the Lord on their life? Come on, somebody. Now, I don't know when you come in my church if you ever read the walls or you ever hear me say, and we live by this, if it ain't Bible, do you believe that? Let's see what the Bible says then. The Bible says, one gives freely. E-church, internet church, Facebook, there are avenues that you can give. Don't you duck and hide because you're on your couch. You be obedient to what God is telling you, and he'll send a blessing right where you sit. You, look at the word. One gives freely, yet grows all the richer. He's not talking about money. He's talking about life more abundantly. He says, look, another withholds what he should give, what God has placed up. This is Bible. One withholds what he should give, and he ends up suffering. Watch this. Whoever, is there any whosoever's in here today? Is there any whosoever's? He said, whosoever brings blessings will, not maybe, Shiloh, will be enriched. He says, the one who waters himself will be watered. He didn't say because the pastor watered. He didn't say because your brother watered. You, when you get to the Bema seat, you can't talk to God about what the pastor gave. He don't want to know what you do with what I gave you. Come on, somebody. This is Bible. So I'm going to ask one question, and I need everybody in the room to shout. It's time to give, Mount Zion. Yeah.
That God is moving right here. So Holy Ghost is here right now. Holy Ghost is here right now. I'm going to write about it right now. Rachel don't play no games. You can get in Rachel's face in the middle of a hoorah moment and say, am I right about it? If she ain't with you, she'll be like, but if she is, she'll be like, she'll play no game. You know, some people just nod because everybody else nod. They'll just say it's good because everybody else says it's good, not Rachel. That's why I like it. Hallelujah. I'm getting ready to open up the altar. And there's healing in this altar. There's healing in this altar today. There's some people in here today that I feel in my spirit want, preacher, I need you an altar, that want to refresh. They want to refresh. Want to refresh. There's some people that want to refresh in the Word of God. There's some people here today that want to renew their spirit in the Word of God. There's some people here today Hallelujah. That just want to call on the name of Jesus. I'm going to open up the altar because we've lost the altar. We've lost the altar. And I'm asking you today, if that's you and you're standing in need of prayer, come to the altar now. If that's you, come on. If you're in need of a refreshing, if you're in need of a restart, a jump start, I need you to come now.
come now. If you're in need of prayer, come now. There's healing. There's deliverance in the altar right now. That's it, my brother. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. Amen. That's it right there. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Let the church. Let the church.
And Yannick. And Yannick. Bring them up right now. Hallelujah.
Let the church.
Hallelujah. Pray with Andy with them right now. I need y'all to touch the dream right here. Andy, she's going to touch the dream. Stretch your hands to these right now, please. Stretch your hands to these. That we would press in with them. Come on. Come on. Come on. Stretch your hands to these in prayer. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Break it. Church, say amen. God is spoken. Let the church say amen. Let the church say
to your feet, all over the building. Stand to your feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Stand to your feet.
Come on.
Is there one that does not know Jesus?
Amen.
Yes, he has. He'll start moving stuff out of the way. If fixing stuff. No problem is too big for the Lord.
Let the church say amen. Let the church.
Hallelujah. Will there be one that does not know Jesus? Is there one? Is there one in the building? Is there one in the building? You see, Kyle, I don't care how good we preach. We preach the paint off the wall, but that don't mean nothing unless we give them an opportunity to know Jesus. Will there be one that does not know Jesus?
Say amen.
Come on, Frank.
Let the church.
Is there one that does not know Jesus?
God has spoken.
Father, we pray right now in Jesus' precious name that you loose a fresh and new anointing upon all of these. Father, I pray that you hide your word in our heart, that we would not sin against you. Lord, let us leave, Lord.
Amen.
With a different way of thinking.
Ooh,
let us leave, Lord,
yes,
with a different
amen.
Way of seeing ourselves.
Amen.
Let us leave, Lord, yes, with a different faith. Let us leave, Lord,
ooh,
accessing
Jesus,
the kingdom of God. Oh, we love you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for shining
amen.
Your face on us today. We thank you, Lord, for the glory showing up in this church. We thank you for your word. What's not me, it was you. We thank you, Jesus.
Yes,
Lord,
amen.
I'm asking for a fresh and new anointing upon these,
that
their lives will give you glory this week. Lord, I'm asking that you put a hedge of protection around their children. I plead the blood of Jesus over each and every one of the families represented here today. I plead the blood. Hallelujah. God, I ask that you smile in their face and you blow the wind at their back. In Jesus' name. And everybody said, I love you, God. I'll see you next Sunday. Hallelujah. 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 Don't forget to sign up at the table for karate.
Let the church.